The rampant spread of coronavirus misinformation is causing many Canadians to question what's true and what's not. A lot of this misinformation is being shared across the internet, especially on social media. So joining us tonight from Calgary to debunk your COVID-19 myths is health researcher Sajjad Fazel. Sajjad, first of all, what prompted you to take up this research?
I've always been interested in health promotion and how we actually educate the public. And health misinformation is one aspect of that. And I've been working in this area for a while now, and seeing how much rampant this misinformation has been just because of this pandemic, it's quite surprising. And it's something that I thought we should research on, and I'm glad to have joined a team of researchers across Canada working on this.
You say it's rampant. Give me an example of how widespread it is.
So every single day, you can say that there is almost a new myth or inaccurate claim about COVID-19, all the way from miracle cures, immune boosting pills, to claims that say this is a bioweapon created by some foreign power.
Okay, well, let's get to our questions tonight, and we'll dig through some of those myths. Our first question tonight comes from Alejandro. Is it true that gargling with salt water can prevent the coronavirus because it increases the alkalinity that kills the virus?
So no, this is not true. Gargling with salt water cannot prevent you, will not prevent you from getting the coronavirus. It has no positive effect in that way. Gargling with salt water or drinking honey and water may help soothe your throat when you have a cold, but it will not prevent, it will not help you or prevent you from being infected with the virus.
Okay. This next question comes from Fatima. Is the coronavirus transmitted through 5G?
Yeah, this myth is going on quite in a large scale in the social media right now. And no, coronavirus cannot be transmitted through 5G. In fact, no viruses can be transmitted through these radio frequencies. And even the myth that radio frequencies or 5G lowers the immune system is also false.
This next question comes from Sandy. What is the story behind the conspiracy theory that this virus is a weapon of mass destruction by either China or Russia gone badly wrong?
So to understand the story behind this, you have to see who is peddling this myth. It's being peddled by two main sources. One is right-wing media and right-wing politicians down in the United States. But at the same time, you see China and Russia spreading the same myth and saying the United States created this virus. Biotechnologists have looked at the virus and have found no evidence that this has been created by men, and in fact have found that this virus came from nature and it was transmitted from an animal to human beings in late of 2019, but there is no evidence that this is a bioweapon, and so that's totally false.
Yeah, there's an opening there for these kinds of conspiracy theories because they are having difficulty tracing, as I understand it. I mean, this changes from day to day. Patient zero and determining exactly how this virus moved from animals to humans.
You're absolutely right, Carol. And I think when there's a gap of evidence or gap of information, and when people hear, oh, we are still finding out, that gives and leaves a room for a lot of misinformation. And that's why we see a lot of misinformation with this virus, because every day we are still developing and researching more about it.
Edward wants to know, would taking vitamin supplements of any kind help boost your immune system to help fight this virus?
So no, taking vitamin supplements will not boost your immune system to help fight this virus. In fact, this concept of boosting the immune system is not true at all. And generally, just taking vitamins, if you do not have any vitamin deficiency, is not advised. The way somebody eats a regular balanced diet with fruits and vegetables, they get their daily intake of vitamins, and they do not need to take or sort of pop these vitamins day in, day out.
Okay, this is a comment from Paige. We have seen numerous stories on social media in the past few days about people believing that they already had the coronavirus back in November or December of 2019. Sajjad, is that possible?
No, I don't think that's possible. And I'll tell you why. According to the government of Canada, the first patient, the first case of coronavirus started showing symptoms on January 15th. And now we know the incubation period of this virus is 14 days. So probably they got infected early January. To say that somebody, that people in Canada had this virus in November, December, no, highly unlikely, because of public health surveillance systems would have picked that up way before that.
Okay, this next comment comes from a viewer writing, everyone should know there is a cure available for very cheap right now. The government is purposely blocking access to it, even though it can save everyone. The ingredients are hydroxychloroquine and azithromycin and zinc sulfate. Sajjad, have you seen this one?
And this is... Hydroxychloroquine was propagated by the President of the United States, and a lot of people have been talking about hydroxychloroquine, azithromycin, and zinc sulfate. These drugs exist. They each treat their own condition. Hydroxychloroquine is used to treat malaria, lupus, and rheumatoid arthritis. Zinc sulfate is used to treat zinc deficiency, even in children. And azithromycin is used to treat bacterial infections, even some sexually transmitted diseases. Whether the combination of these drugs is effective in terms of in treating COVID-19, the evidence is still very shady. There are some research, there is some healthcare professionals in various countries who have said that there is some benefit, or it sort of assisted them in treating patients with COVID-19. But there is also research that shows that there is no effectiveness of these medications. And so more research is needed before we can say whether these medications have any benefit at all in terms of assisting those who have tested positive with COVID-19. Also, these medications have side effects. They can cause cardiac arrhythmias and some other serious side effects when given together. And finally, I think a lot of people have started buying up these medications all over the world, and they've created a shortage for those people who actually need them for the conditions they treat.
I'm going to mention to our audience now that you are a doctor of pharmacy, so you know these medications very, very well. Finally, tonight, what's most concerning to you? What has stood out for you in your research?
And what has stood out to me is the wide reach of misinformation that is there concerning COVID-19. You have myths that start from India, something like, oh, hold your breath for 10 minutes, and if you don't cough, you don't have COVID, which is totally false. And it spreads all the way to Canada, and then myths that start in the United States go all the way to China and so forth. So because we live in a world that is connected digitally, myths and false and inaccurate claims spread all over the world. So what I would advise everyone listening is that if you get something, or somebody sent you something or shared something with you, whether it's a post on Facebook, something on Twitter or WhatsApp, have a look at it, check the source, fact check it with a government website, with the Public Health Agency of Canada, WHO, and see whether it's true or not. If it's not true, do not share it at all. You all can play a part and a role in stopping the spread of misinformation.
Yeah, the problem here is that a lot of people don't trust government.
True. And that is one of the things that you see coming up, especially when you see somebody say, oh, the cure is hidden, or this was a bioweapon. And I think those who do peddle these myths, they have some sort of a benefit for it. For example, a very famous doctor in the United States who's running for Senate right now is propagating the fact that this is all a deep state conspiracy. Again, that's helping him to rally up his base for his Senate race. And so similarly, you see somebody YouTubing false claims about the coronavirus or miracle cures to bring in more viewers. So everyone has some sort of benefit. Those who are selling the herbal medications, they have their own benefit financially. So I think it's for us all to be cognizant that there are people who are benefiting from this calamity and from spreading misinformation.
Sajjad Fazel, health research.